Yeah, since NumPy comparison operators and selection masks are so much fun, let's do another video on it. So previously we already introduced masks and comparison operators. However, I wanted to show you some additional tricks that you can use when working with these. So here, let's start with a simple example. We have a NumPy array 1, 2, 3, 4, just to keep it simple. And then we can define a mask for selecting values. And this mask will be a Boolean array. So that's something we've seen before. And it will be true for all values in the array or all positions in the array that match the condition that the values are bigger than 2. So the mask array will always be the same size or shape as the original array. However, the true values are the positions where this condition is true, and the other ones are the one where the condition is false. And then we can use the mask to select values from that array. Again, when we have the mask in Python, there's a way, for example, that we can the notion is basically the number 1 and the bool of true are the same thing. So if we convert true value to an integer, it will be a 1, and false is a 0. And this is why we can do things like, let's say, some condition 1 equals 2. So if this condition is true, we can say if condition print this is true. So this is something that works in Python. It's kind of like the same thing as writing this. However, in Python it's best practice to just avoid equals true. So, and similarly you can write this one, if not condition. So this might means basically this whole thing means the same as if condition equals false. Yeah, and the same thing would apply if we put a 0 here. So if not condition, this would also print this statement because this is the same as false. And this is the same as true. So because of the relationship between Boolean values and the integer values 1 and 0, we can actually count the elements in an array that match a certain condition using the sum operator. So here, for example, we have all the values that are greater than 2. So in this case, there are 2 true values. And if we have a large array, of course, we cannot really look at it and count it by hand. It would be too much work, right? So we can use the sum operator. And this will give us the sum of this mask here. So in this way, it will count the values that are true. And then similarly, you can get the values that are negative by just the shape minus the sum, right? So this would be values where it's false, the number of values. Or we could also technically, just to go back because I just see the next example here, we could technically also, if we wanted to compute the number of negative values, we can also use the NumPy invert function. So again, if we have the mask, this will give us the... Actually, let's extend this to more values, then this will return a 3 for all the positive matches. And then if I want to the negative matches, which are the number 2 now, because we have 2 false and 3 truths, if I want to count the number of falses, I can also use NumPy invert, where NumPy invert will invert these values here. So false will become true and true becomes false. You can see that here. So I can count the number of negative values by calling invert first. Why is that useful? So let's assume we have a case where we have our array here and we want these values to be, let's say, the value 1 and these values to be the value 0, like binarizing this array. So what we could do is we can say all the values in the array that are greater than 2. And let's do the mask first. Let's do mask 1, all the values greater than 2, and the mask 2 for all the values that are not greater than 2, which would be then mask invert, NumPy invert mask 1. And then we can set the values to 1 and, okay, so this should be then a binarized array. So we binarized our array here. However, this can be a lot of typing work, right? So we would have to type that all out. A simpler way doing that is using the NumPy where function. So NumPy where function works as follows. It's basically doing what we've done here above. It checks a condition, and for all the values where the condition is true, it assigns this value, the first value, and for all the values where the condition is false, it will assign this value. So this one will also then do the same binarization. Yeah, and I just see another way of doing the NumPy invert is just using this tilde symbol. It's the same as doing invert. So if we have our mask, say mask 1, I call NumPy invert. This is the same. I'm not sure if it works actually outside the indexing. This would be the same as doing mask 1. Yeah, it does actually. So this is just a operator overloading of the NumPy invert function here. So we can also do this one instead of this one. But personally, I just use NumPy where if I only have two decisions here. If I have something like greater than 2, I want to assign it a 1, otherwise a 0, I would just use NumPy where, because it's just one line of code where this one or this one is a little bit more involved. Okay, so with that operator, there are also other types of operators that come in handy in practice. So the common ones, or I think these are actually all of them, are AND, OR, XOR, and NOT. So this is the NOT operator. And what's nice in NumPy is we can combine them. So we can say, for example, all the values that are greater than 3 or are smaller than 2. So let's extend that. So it will then select all the values greater than 3, which are 4 and 5, right? And smaller than 2, it's only the 1. So what it should return is 1, 4, 5, right? Oh, sorry, it's just the mask, but if we would apply the mask, it would be 1, 4, 5. And then we can also do the same thing with the NOT, so that in that case would be the 2 and 3. And then, yeah, we can also use, for example, the AND operator, so we can say all the values, let's say they are greater than 3 and divisible by 2. So it would be only the number 4. Should then return the number 4. Oh, sorry. Actually, I wanted to use the AND here. And so forth. And yeah, this is all the nice things about Boolean masks and selection masks and operators, logical operators in NumPy. I think this is super cool and helpful in practice if we manipulate data sets and so forth. And we will be using that quite a lot later when we are implementing certain decision tree rules and the homeworks and stuff like that. But yeah, that is all I wanted to say here. In the next video, we will be covering some basic linear algebra concepts in NumPy.